It's a check for $10,000.
And then BAM! It's motivated the emotion! Hi there, welcome to my channel. My name is Hayden Hillier-Smith. I have been in the YouTube industry for over 10 years, and I would say professionally for the past 4. And of those 4 years, I have edited for the YouTube vlogger Logan Paul, and we have spent a considerable amount of time developing and understanding what it is to make the perfect YouTube video. Now, the initial reaction of a YouTube editor is, oh, you're editing YouTube videos. That's pretty basic, boring, and you have no skill. Which is a genuine misconception. Editing a YouTube video is genuinely challenging because you have to present the best pieces of information as quickly as possible while competing with all the other videos that are begging for your attention and every other application that you have on your mobile device or on your computer that's also begging for your attention. So you have to make the most engaging video possible and so you never click away. Up front, I wanted to start a React channel because the other creator, Jordan Orm, started reacting to professional music videos with his background as a professional music video director. And one of the sentiments that he said was,
lots of YouTubers like to break down specific effects. I'm gonna bring other value to the table and bring you inside of the psychology of humans, how watching certain things makes us feel.
I've always agreed with that. I want to give more insight onto the psychology and subconscious influence that editing can have. Why did they cut here and why is that the most effective reason? Now getting started, I want to react to what I think is the best YouTube video of this year so far. David Dobrik's We Can't Believe This Happened.
Hey guys, it's David. How do I even start this?
Great. This is already a really, really good start. Normally, the videos open up with a joke, a quick opening joke, and then he plays a theme tune.
Not quite as sexy as me, but...
Already he's set up that this is a different video by the fact that he doesn't do that. So bam, your expectations have already been thrown off and he's already now got your attention. Ooh, what's different here?
Where do I begin?
Where do I even start?
And bam, within 8 seconds, the video has already had a big laugh. David has a phenomenal understanding that laughter, well, was the best way to break the ice. That's why his vlogs always start with a big giant laugh in the first 5 to 10 seconds. He's following the same philosophy as canned laughter. This is the same way that when you're watching Friends or The Big Bang Theory or Frasier, they do a joke and there's laughter, and you are now more subconsciously inclined to laugh yourself.
You can make yourself a pair of face pants and she won't know the difference.
And that is a massive psychological trick that has worked for decades, and David has now brought that into the YouTube platform. And so just with that very intentional big piece of laughter, you've let your guard down, you're now more engaged in the video, and you now want to watch more, and you relate to him on a significant level, which now gives him the perfect opportunity to, well, build up to what's happening next.
I have been hooking up with Natalie. So yes, if you guys want to, it's not a joke, we seriously have, like, we've run out of options.
Yeah.
We've gotten a lot of messages from you guys that have been affected by all this corona stuff, and it sucks, and I really wanted to see if I can help. So I partnered with my friends at EA, and we did just that.
That's why he did the 2 icebreakers, because this is a sponsored video. One of the biggest dangers about having a sponsored video is it can take away some of the authenticity. It can create a slight bad taste in your mouth where it looks like he's doing what he's doing, not because he wants to, but because he's been paid to do so. To combat that, David Dobrik had 2 big jokes and laughs before he even mentioned the fact that this is a sponsored video.
Where do I even start? I have been hooking up with Natalie.
Yeah.
By already giving you 2 jokes, he has asked permission for you to accept the fact that this is a sponsored video. We're already 30 seconds in and David Dobrik has already expressed phenomenal mastercraft. This is why he's one of the most popular creators on the platform.
Guys, look at this. This is what hard work looks like. Look at all this equally working hard.
I'll hold the camera. You fucking lift something.
No, man, this is important. I got you this part.
So he has already now set up some really, really good momentum just with that small mini montage. He's now set the feel. It is your job as an editor to present the emotion that they had when filming. And one of the best ways you can do that is with your choice of music. So that high tone and rhythmic piano and those claps, well, those are some happy emotions, my friend. So here's the next smart thing. He's already set up a pretty decent rhythm with this song, and he's gonna take advantage of that rhythm by cutting to the beat.
No,
one,
this is important.
2, 3, 4, and...
Shit.
Do you see that? There was a rhythm. The next cut played with the rhythm. You were expecting the next clap of that beat, and it said it presented you with a whole new cut that was exactly on that rhythm. So what he's done is a tone change. It's like as if you're watching a whole new video. And this is great because what that means is if you're watching a whole new video, you're not going to click on all the other videos that are unrecommended that are demanding your attention. He has presented a new video already for you. Every 10, 20, 30 seconds, you need a genuinely new piece of information that is engaging content to maintain their focus on your video. If you don't consistently make them re-engage, they're going to click off. And that is the worst thing for any creator. Gotta exploit expectations and throw them off. Just for that small sequence there is excellent because he's already acknowledged the biggest challenge of this video. So this small sequence here is pretty much just setting up the rules of this entire video. The exposition of Act 1. It's setting up and building the world. And he is now going to pretty much show the same shot for over 3 minutes.
That's going to get really boring. Really quickly.
You are going to have to be really, really smart in editing to have this consistently be entertaining. Let's find out how he does it. And so now look at that. He's already sped up the editing by cutting out the information that we no longer need. We no longer need to see him giving the products. We need to see the reactions. And he's now compiling them into a small sequence. And again, cutting to the beat with faster editing. So he's already picked up the pace and also showing us brand new information. And these shots are so quick. You barely actually see the reactions because, well, the point's already been made. Reaction. Great. Happy. Move on. Liz, what's next? He doesn't need to hang around that much. The emotion and feel is already there is people happily receiving iPads. We need to move on quickly because that feeling is going to dissipate very fast. And he knows that. That's excellent because that's a really smartly placed shot. You've just had a repetition of shots. You've now set up an expectation. He's now set up a feeling. He's now thrown in another curveball and also an expression of his personality and character. Actually, it's kind of like a break. It's a breather. This is an excellent comedic moment that gives you a break so he can now have more permission to get back into showing the repetitive shots. And there it is. He just did it a second time. This montage would be incredibly boring if we didn't have those moments in between. It just maintains momentum and it ensures that the montage does not get repetitive. See, this is really smart progression. He's already identified that the shot of him handing an iPad or a PlayStation to someone is already such a boring shot because we've seen it 20 times already. You gotta spice it up. It's the same shot of him gifting, but now it is an extra bit of flair to it. He has now raised the bar ever so slightly so you remain engaged.
The next girl's name is Abby. She's 19, recently unemployed, and she really wants a new Xbox.
That was genius what just happened there. So we just had 5 to 6 shots of people reacting. The editing slowed down significantly there as well, so we really get those moments to breathe. But deep down at the back of your mind, these cuts were slow, they were very repetitive, and actually, the energy kind of starts to dip. And so what do? You gotta throw in another curveball. What he's now done is he's transitioned into Act 2 of the video. What I'm now starting to do is characterize the people who are receiving these gifts and giving context and giving, well, character development as to who these people are. He is now changing the relationship for your audience to be more interested into who these people are. Rather than just random people receiving PlayStations, there's now more context to them. You're now more engaged.
But then he does something really, really smart.
Oh my God, David Dobrik, hi.
Stay there. Are you Abby?
No, Abby.
He's now done excellent use of meta comedy. It is an expression of self-awareness to what you are doing and to make fun of your actions. It's an element of self-referential self-parody of yourself. And so for you to express how aware of what you are and what you're doing and make a big joke out of it, it actually makes you considerably more relatable. It's now far more entertaining because he's aware of what he's doing.
Can I shoot a t-shirt cannon at you?
Great. He is utilizing what he did back in Act 1. Act 1 was fast. Act 1 had a lot of information. Act 1 was aggressive. And because of that, he is now built this really good energy up here. What it means is if you've got the energy up here, you can let things breathe. So if the previous montage was constant information of, look at all this cool shit I'm giving away, you can now have a moment to breathe on a genuine reaction that has played out over a significant amount of time. Because things are breathing now, it's a completely different presentation. And because of that, nothing gets stale. And so now we're getting more genuine reactions that we now get to enjoy. It's fantastic.
I shoot a t-shirt cannon at you.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1.
What the fuck are you doing?
I don't know.
And then inside, I put a little gift for you.
Thank you.
It's a check for $10,000.
He is so good at using music to motivate emotion. A significant amount of editing is just presenting emotion. What does he do here? Let's break it down. We're having some lovely music. And then bang! Music is aggressively cut. This is like another form of meta editing. Imagine if the live band, and like, yeah, this is great music. Oh my god, what the fuck? It's like as if even the music or the band is like, what the fuck is going on here? Emphasizes the joke.
It's a check for $10,000.
And then bam, it motivates the emotion. You're now seeing it through the perspective of the people who are receiving the gifts. Imagine the shock they get. You now get a check for $10,000. That elevation, emotional elevation you're gonna get. How do you present that in editing? He did it in the most basic way, music.
It's a check for $10,000.
It's so simple, but so effective of using music to motivate emotional elation. Now you are related to them. It's like as if you just received the gift and you continue this song for the rest of this montage and you're emotionally connected to every single person for the rest of this montage. See, I'm related to all of them. This is so much fun. I'm repeating myself at this point now. He has now expressed more character and personality of banter with his friends by shooting him in the leg with a paintball gun. Bam! Refreshed! And now you can have these emotional moments. Same thing again. He's now letting these moments breathe. He has now built up that energy here so he can slowly dip it down with these really nice moments of intimate emotional beats. And then at some point he's going to identify that the energy is dipped again and he's going to have to raise it back up. I bet you that's what he's going to do. See that? 1, 2, 3. Cars! Fucking cars! Bam! That is another escalation in energy. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bam! He is still using music as a big emotional motivator. Escalation of the song happens at the same moment that they are revealed the information that they got the car, makes them even more relatable. And then out. Out. He's out. The video's ended. Oh. What just happened? The video's over. Because he knows when not to hang around. We've had this same experience for 3 minutes now. We're gonna get bored. The smartest thing to do is know when to quit, know when to end. Always end on the high note, and that's exactly what he did. Here's one of the best reactions. It's a fucking car.
Get the fuck out!
If you like this video, please let me know. I'm going to start making some more if this, works out quite nice and lovely and jubbly. As I said earlier, I think this is one of the best videos released this year. But what about you? What is your favorite YouTube video ever created by a YouTube creator? Send it to me, let me know in the comments, and I'll see if I can react to them. One of the videos I'm going to react to next is one of my favorite videos ever created by Casey Neistat. Since I have been Logan Paul's editor for the past 4 years, I will also react and deconstruct some of my editing choices that I made in some of Logan Paul vlogs. There is more react content to come, so thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys again soon. Running through the city till I drop.